Welcome to another video in my PBX showcase series. In this video, I just wanted to highlight a few quick updates since my last video. First of all, you can see my Linksys PAP2T analog telephone adapter back there. You'll recall I had it connected to a router yesterday to get it hooked up to the net, but you'll notice that I do not have an Ethernet cable trailing along the floor here as I did in my last video, which I actually recorded yesterday. So what I have instead, it's still hooked up. There's an Ethernet cable connected back there. And the other end of it is plugged in to this, if you can see it, this TP-Link 200 megabits per second Powerline adapter. I've actually never used one of these up until now. And it's performing quite well, actually. There's been no difference in its the connection speed or quality since switching from a direct Ethernet connection to this Powerline unit. And this way I don't have this Ethernet cable running along the floor and out the door. It's just plugged in here. So again, I have this Powerline adapter connected here. And obviously, Powerline adapters come in pairs. So I'll show you where the other Powerline adapter is. So the other Powerline adapter I actually have by the computer here, and the reason the computer is here is because there is an Ethernet port in the wall here. And I'm afraid the lighting isn't terribly well. But you can see we've got electrical connections back there and a Powerline adapter right there. So there's only one Ethernet port here. So actually what I have is a switch connected to that Ethernet port. This computer here is connected to one of the ports, and the other port I have an Ethernet cable plugged into it, and that is connected to the other Powerline adapter here, which is paired with the one upstairs. So I've moved the monitor slightly so you can see what's going on here. You'll see there's the Ethernet port in the wall, and there's an Ethernet cable connected to that switch there. You can see in the back with the green light. And then again, one of those cables is connected to the computer here. And the other cable is connected to the Powerline adapter, which you can see plugged into the bottom right there. And finally, this Ethernet port here must be connected to something. So the other end of that Ethernet port going back upstairs again now is actually in this closet here. I don't know if you can see too well. There are a couple cables here, actually. There's three cables coming in here, and that red one is the cable connected to the other end of that jack downstairs. And that red cable plugs into the back of the router, which is right here. So by using both Powerline and the existing Ethernet wiring in this building, we still have the ATA connected to the internet. So next, I have this avocado green Western Electric 500 telephone. It's not wired up because, as you can see, the tip has just been cut off here. So my next project is going to be getting this wired up so I can actually use this. But it's quite nice. It's hardwired. The only other hardwired telephone I have is this 302 right here. And that I used unused wall jack to connect the hardwired part of this to a modular cord. So I'm not sure if I'll do something similar to get this hooked up. But anyways, that'll be my next project. It's got a very long line cord. I think this is about 25 or maybe 30 feet. And otherwise, it's in good condition. The dial spins nicely. So I don't think it needs any maintenance apart from getting this hooked up here. So in addition to this nice green 500. I also have this 2500 phone, and this is not a vintage phone. It's actually a reproduction phone, made recently by Cortelco. It's a Cortelco 2500, and you'll notice that it's not quite the same as a Western Electric 2500 telephone. For one, it's not made by Western Electric, but there's actually several other differences. I can't demonstrate in this video, but it's actually much lighter than a 2500 or a 500 standard telephone. It's much lighter, and that's because it has a lot of integrated circuitry inside. It's not built like the old Western Electric 2500s. It's definitely not as reliable, but it still works nicely. And if I turn around here, you'll see that there's actually two jacks in the back. There's one for the line to plug into, and there's another port for data. So I guess the idea here is you can plug your computer modem or something like that into this data jack right here. But the line cord plugs into this jack on the right here. If we turn upside down, you'll notice it doesn't have their traditional wheel that most Western Electric phones have to adjust the ringer, such as this phone here. If I turn this upside down, you'll notice that there's a finger wheel you can use to adjust the volume. This phone, on the other hand, only has a switch. So you can switch it to one of, I believe, two or three positions, but not somewhere in between. In addition to that, the handset itself has volume adjustment, but it's not the volume adjustment that G6 handsets had. So, for example, this handset, it's got the wheel adjustment. Again, just like the volume adjustment for their bell ringer, this has a fixed adjustment that can just be in a couple of places. You can move it up or down, and it has three positions in the middle, top, or bottom, but it can't be anywhere in between. Other than that, it's nicely built. It's working fine. They're obviously not on par with the Western Electric 2500, but they definitely look nice, and there's no reason why they can't be used. So I'm going to do a demonstration of this phone now. I'll simply disconnect the cord from this phone and plug it into the line port on this phone. And we have dial tone. I guess I'll just call this phone right here. So the touch tone dial works fine. And we can call this phone now. I'll use this phone right here to call it. So you'll notice that the ringer actually sounds quite different from the Western Electric 2500 or 500. So to give you an idea of what the 500 or 2500 would sound like, I can call this phone here so you can hear what a Western Electric 2500 might sound like. So you can definitely hear that there is a difference in terms of what the ringer sounds like. So I've connected the line cord back to this 500 telephone here with the adjustable volume. So I'll make it as loud as it gets so it's easier to hear. And I'm just gonna show you a couple other cool things with CNET here. Like I said, the PAP2T ATA that I have does not support pulse dialing, but this PBX down here acts as a pulse-to-tone converter for external calls. So actually, I can demonstrate that here by lifting the receiver connected to this, connected to the PAP2T directly and not to the PBX. You can faintly hear the PAP2T dial tone here. And I can make a call to through the PAP2T, and you'll hear the tones faintly out of this receiver. I'll dial 9 for an outside line. 1. And I'll start over because just like the PBX, dial tone here times out after a few seconds. 9 for an outside line. Dial tone. And you can hear the tones through here. So if I dial 8, I'll dial a famous number here. Again, you can hear the tones coming out of here. And we can put this one back on hook now. So somebody obviously thought it would be funny to assign the phone number used in the song 867-5309 to the CNET number. So there's actually a CNET number 1-867-5309, and if you call that, it plays that song. So just another one of the quirky things on CNET. Well, hang up now. And I'm just going to dial a couple other CNET numbers here. Again, there's a 10-15 second delay, because we don't have a pound here. So you might be asking, what's the point of this? Believe me, I asked the same question. All sorts of funky stuff out there on CNET. So I'll call another number now. And this number, actually, contains recordings from, I think, all the Asterix funny recordings. There's a bunch of funny recordings that obviously aren't being used, and the guy who's running this, he's compiled them all into a nice audio recording that uses them all. So, dial 9 for an outside line, and then the CNET number.
is not welcome. This voice path is insecure. Do not discuss classified information or use project code words. This highway leads to the shadowy tip of reality. You're on a through route to the land of the different, the bizarre, the unexplainable. Go as far as you like on this road. Its limits are only those of the mind itself. Ladies and gentlemen, you're entering the wondrous dimension of imagination. Next up, the Code Zone. Woohoo! Your call is now first in line and will be answered by the next available representative. Yeah! Would you mind if I showed you how we do it in Canada? We don't have tech support. Due to the presence of zombies at the location you have dialed, the office has been evacuated. Please leave a message, and we will return your call as soon as possible. Unless, of course, the apocalypse occurs first. In this event, we'll likely have other priorities. You sound cute. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. You seem impatient. Wrong.
So basically, this is a recording featuring a bunch of recordings that really you would never hear on the telephone. And I think this recording is about 10 minutes long, if I remember correctly. I listened to it in its entirety once. So I'll just hang up now. If you're interested, you can dial the CNET number for that 1-938-0998 if you want to listen to that recording in its entirety. And if you're not on CNET, again, you can use one of the CNET gateways. Right now, we'll just dial some other numbers to wrap up. And these are numbers from a switch in Oregon. I dialed some of those numbers in my last video. We'll have to start over. There's no back on a rotary phone, of course. And the note that I have for this number is SCXY vacuum tube. Vacuum tube. So, you're gonna hear some vacuum tubes in a moment. So this is the busy signal being generated in this vacuum tube system. And this should be a standard ring from that vacuum tube system. And indeed it is. And I'll end here by dialing the number that will give us an intercept announcement. It'll be intercepted. You can dial any number in the 462 office code for this. That begins with 62. So I've just dialed, in the 462 office code 6233. And you'll hear the intercept announcement for that.
46262.
So you can hear that it's not just a generic intercept announcement. It's actually customized for the number we dialed. So all that, I'll end here. I don't know if you can hear my stomach growling, but I should probably go eat something. So hopefully you enjoy this video. Just some updates on the Cortelco 2500 and the Western Electric 500 there, as well as Powerline networking for my PAP2T, and doing some dialing around CNET to some of the cool/funny/funky stuff that's out there. So I hope you enjoyed.